Member for Peace River North.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Today I'm going to be talking to briefly on an organization that all of us know and appreciate, the Salvation Army. This is an international organization that began its work in Canada in 1882 and has grown to become the largest non-governmental direct provider of social services in our country. The Salvation Army offers practical assistance for children and families, often tending to the basic necessities of life, providing shelter for homeless people or supports for those in addiction. In Fort St. John, their food bank operates on a drop-in basis. People can come in, have a cup of coffee, grab a snack, or sign up for a food bank slot. The community meal program brings guests in to enjoy fellowship, games, and access to caseworkers, or just a hot lunch. In addition to food, many people are in need of clothing or household items and can find support there. Additionally, the Salvation Army's Northern Center of Hope in Fort St. John has designed a proactive program for those who have reached a point in their lives where they are ready to move forward out of poverty and address the barriers that prevent the acquisition of sustained housing and career employment. The primary goal is to integrate these individuals back into the community as self-sufficient citizens. There is little doubt, Mr. Speaker, that 2020 has been one of the most challenging years ever, which has presented significant hurdles for the Salvation Army and many organizations like it. Christmas can be an extra hard season for people with low income and much worse under COVID-19 conditions. Thank you to all the Salvation Armies across the province. I want to give special thanks to our local executive director, Cameron Agee, and all of his staff and volunteers who are very thankful for the generosity of residents in our community, for their continued support. The request for service remains high and ongoing. There is greater diversity of food bank users than ever before from people that were not prepared for layoffs or revenue interruption. The same theme is taking place across our province. Mr. Speaker, Christmas kettles will be out this year. They may or may not have a volunteer. Some will have a $5 tap feature for your debit card or credit card. Whatever the case may be, please give generously. Thank you.